John and the Crib here, and basically today we are in makeup class for Sister Whitfield, and we're gonna see kind of what it's like when girls put on makeup. Fortunately, I'm the only guy in this classroom, and so I'm just gonna take pictures of girls putting makeup on.
What are you doing?
I'm just getting shots of people doing makeup. Pretend like I'm not even here. This is Brittany.
Hi. Don't judge me by the way I look.
And there's our teacher. While we're working, she just reads.
Right.
This is Nikki. She's already put on corrective makeup, and she is in the process of putting on glamour.
Now, should I have the beauty mark right here or right here?
Down on the bottom. Otherwise, you got the Cindy Crawford look, and that's just kind of sick. And then the other day, I put makeup on myself, and I enjoyed it. Perhaps a little too much. This is Brittany. Her corrective makeup is now finished. She looks beautiful.
I look like a hooker. But you're supposed to see this from way far away.
Exactly. So that's what we're going to do. Wow, from back here, you're beautiful. But now that we're closing up, she still looks like a hooker. Here she is, straight from the 80s. This is my first draft. We're gonna make slight changes. And she sort of resembles like a mix between a prostitute and a clown from the 80s. She hated it. She was like, you did it all wrong.
No.
And then I almost started to cry.
No, Jenny.
I'm a failure. Do you do your makeup like that? Oh, you're washing it off! I thought you were gonna go to the Nordic and we were walking the Nordic like that. And then I was gonna be like, hey, this is my girl. Okay, this is Emily without any makeup on. We are going to put glamour makeup on her just like we did Brianna the other day.
I think you look beautiful, Emily.
Sexy. Bow, bow. Now she's got her hair down. Oh, man.
I'll be your Huckleberry. Doc Holliday here. And today for makeup class, we're doing a little beards and mustaches. Yeah!
What are you calling me girly? I'm not girly, I'm a dude.
For all those of you who are watching, this is not a voiceover. This is not just a picture of a tree because it's not a normal tree. I am the tree, and I was camouflaged, as you can see. Because today, for makeup class, it's Inanimate Object Day, and I am a tree.
Plate of food.
Hi.
And I'm gonna eat her. Ew, dude, that would be sick, because then I would start eating, and then you'd be like, and then it would be like the plate was eating me. Lick the lollipop.
Okay, I'm the sky, right?
All right.
Watch this.
Dude, the bird's flying.
Is that exciting?
Mm-hmm. Here, we've got an iPod. That's pretty dang good, actually. Oh my goodness, it is.
Now it's Chinese Kubusuki Day, so we're doing kabuki. We're doing kabuki Chinese-Japanese fighters who are on the stage.
Like Mexican wrestlers.
Hello, John the Crib here. Today for makeup class, we're doing Animal Day, where we become different animals. And if you didn't know, I am a zebra, or a Maui warrior. And so we're gonna see what other animals we have here in this zoo of makeup class.
Here we've got a... Are you gonna bark for us? Come on, bark for us. Well, I like the neck. We've got a long neck from a giraffe. Make the sound of a giraffe.
What sound do they make?
Yeah, I'm not so sure.
Okay. I'm a fish.
A fish, definitely an undersea creature. You look like creature from the Blue Lagoon. Okay, we got Nikki, and she made a...
My Dalmatian.
Dalmatian. We've got a butterfly here. Flip, flippity, flappity, flip. Nice.
I don't know how to butterflies move.
Yeah, you got it. If you can only do that with your face. Meanwhile, Hannah's way behind because she decided to shave her head bald. We got Brittany making herself a beautiful butterfly.
You and me, baby, ain't nothing but mammals, so let's do it.
Discovery Channel.
Do it again now.
You and me, baby, ain't nothing but mammals, so let's do
it. Okay, we've got the beginnings of, I'm guessing, a cheetah or at least some type of cat.
Leopard.
Make a leopard sound for us.
Rawr.
Hey, make a panda noise.
What's a panda noise?
Okay, we've got a raccoon here. Make a raccoon noise.
I don't know what they mean.
It's like this. A lion. Are you gonna do the hair thing?
No.
Are you gonna growl for me?
Yeah.
Do it.
That was like a gurgly growl.
Okay, here we got another raccoon.
I don't know.
Do they make this sound?
That's what I thought it was.
Today for makeup, we're actually starting blood, guts, and gore. In particular, guts. We're going to take pig fetuses and have them hanging out of our stomachs after we apply wounds to make it look like our guts are hanging out.
I got punched right in the face.
I got punched by my roommate.
And I'm running past Porter Park and, you know, dangerous gangs hang out over there, so they jumped out of nowhere and they strangled me and slit me across the cheek with their knife, and I beat them up though.
Voltron is my arch nemesis, but not for long, because soon I'll pretty much be dead. So, Brittany, what happened to you?
Well, Johnny, see,
oh my gosh.
I was riding in the back of my brother's truck yesterday, and my best friend, I thought she was my best friend. She decided to push me out and I landed right on my face. Slid. Just like that.
So today for makeup class we're doing mimes.
Clown.
Could you tell what I was doing? I was in a box and it was closing in on me. Hey, do a mime impression. Whoa, that's cool. Dude, that was awesome. See, I was walking with the rope and all of a sudden somebody let go of the rope and I fell back. Hey, if you were mine, what would your name be? Well, that looks really cool. What's your name?
Sparkles.
Now I'm Data from Star Trek. Well, I don't know, Captain Picard. I'm a robot, that's all.
To be your friend today. So Bullseye, what he does is he takes little kids.
What clown name are you?
I haven't one.
You have to make up a clown name.
I don't have a clown name, Johnny.
How about Psycho the Freaky Clown? How about that?
Put it on that.
Did
side
I do
of your
him
face.
On the right? Is it the same?
Hey everybody!
What, did you choose a name?
Splotchy?
I think your name should be Crayola.
Crayola the Clown? Actually,
yep.
Yeah, I like that. Crayola the Clown.
What was it, Blinky?
Sparkles.
Oh, okay. Jeez.
Back in our makeup class again, and now we're gonna do old age makeup, which is where we make ourselves really old. You're about to be age-ified,
oldified.
Because when you get old, your face starts to deepen and shadow and eyes.
Tell us what you like about the makeup class.
I like that it's not too much preparation, yeah. And I can just come and relax for a little while.
Ew. How would you like to kiss those? You need whiskers.
Yeah. And it makes me feel artistic even though I'm not at all.
Old people, do you notice how they always have mean looks on their face like this?
And they're moving.
And they tick like that.
Join the dark side.
Join. My name's Frank. Came up to Rexburg around 19 giggity doo.
You're like, hey, what can I get you today here at your friendly McDonald's? And they're like,
I just want a cheeseburger.
And you're like, geez, you don't gotta get all mad about it. They're probably not mad. They're just oval.
Hey, I think I'd like to live here for a little while. So what do you?
Right now we're applying cold cream because his face, it just needs some.
He's getting some beautiful shots.
When I got here, I was like, lived here about 50, 60 years. I was like, I kind of like this place. Reminds me of home.
And now we're in for the next extra dry. I can try it as hard as I can. And then I am not yet, I'm far away.
Oh my gosh, you look insane.
Here with my friend Sam. We both have old age makeup on.
Old man!
Go ahead and show the extreme old age side.
Now the non-extreme old age side.
Oh, careful.
And I was like, hey Agatha, would you like to go on a date with me?
So pretty much we've invented this thing where instead of shaving with razors, you can shave with baby wipes. Check it out. Isn't that amazing? How that just comes off like that. It's incredible.
I need some change.
It also takes away wrinkles. Pretty much if we got married and we got old, we would look like this.
Oh, okay, I'm just gonna say, we went to the drive-in, we were making out. And then, we stopped for a second and I put a little flavored lip gloss on. Some yummy watermelon.
Watermelon? That time.
I don't know if you guys know yet, but I used to give kissing lessons to people, and so I'm gonna give you guys a few tips. It's like this. First, you start kissing like this. Just a little bit.
Then we started making out again, and he was a little surprised, but he liked it a lot.
A little bit at a time. And then, as you're kissing, then you let just a little tongue. Just a little tongue like this. And it was kind of like this.
Get down.
One more tongue. And then like. This is the final makeup day. Check out the technique with the pen on the neck. You've got the nose, beautiful eyes, and then the best part is the little streaks of hair. Here we've got Mystique.
I have it, but I forgot to print it out. Is it okay if I bring it to you later?
With clothes on, but that's okay.
Yeah, okay.
Sorry to disappoint you.
So. Now we have Brittany. What are you, Brittany?
The Cheshire Cat.
Check out the nose. She has no nostrils. She is breathing through her mouth.
The wiggly smile.
We've got a little munchkin. Do the little lollipop song.
We represent the lollipop. I don't know.
Kids. Yar! My name's Black Sam Bellamy, Pirate of the Wide Eye. Black Sam Bellamy was a pirate according to National Geographic who crashed the Wide Eye, and the recovering of the Wide Eye ended up being the greatest treasure hunting discovery of all time because there was like millions of dollars of gold and silver there.